The Jellyfish and the Monkey. Long ago, in old Japan, in the days where the jellyfish was a hard creature with a shell and bones, the oceans were governed by Rinjin, the Dragon King of the Sea. He was the ruler of all sea creatures, both great and small, and lived in a palace at the bottom of the sea, so beautiful that no one has ever seen anything like it, even in dreams. But despite all this, the Dragon King was not happy, for he reigned on his own and was lonely. Finally, he decided to find a wife and called several fish ambassadors to search the oceans for a suitable bride. At length, they brought to the palace a lovely young dragon with scales like a glittering green of the wave and eyes the gleaming white of pearls, whom the king fell in love with at once. The wedding was celebrated with great splendor, and every living thing in the oceans rejoiced, from the hugest whale to the tiniest shrimp. The Dragon King and his bride were very happy together, but for just 2 months, for then the Dragon Queen suddenly fell very ill. The desperate king ordered the best doctor and nurses to look after her, but instead of getting better, the young queen grew gradually worse. The doctor tried to excuse himself by saying that although he knew the right kind of medicine, it was impossible to find it in the sea.
"Please tell me what it is,"
demanded the Dragon King. "The liver cut from a live monkey," answered the doctor. "If we could only get that, Her Majesty will soon recover."
"Well, even though we sea creatures cannot live the ocean, we must get a monkey to cut up somehow," decided the king. He called his chief steward for advice, who thought for some time and declared,
"I know! The jellyfish is ugly to look at, but he has a hard shell and 4 bony legs, and can walk on land. An island where there are monkeys lies a few hours' swim to the south. Let us send the jellyfish there. If he can't catch a monkey, maybe he can trick one into coming here." The jellyfish was summoned and ordered to entice a monkey to the Dragon King's palace. Although very worried about the task, the poor jellyfish had no choice but to swim off at once. Luckily, when he reached Monkey Island, he saw a big pine tree, and on one of its branches was just what he was looking for, a live monkey.
"How do you do, Mr. Monkey?" called the jellyfish, thinking quickly of a plan. "Isn't it a lovely day?" he added politely.
"A very fine day," answered the monkey. "I have never seen you before. What is your name?"
"My name is Jellyfish. I have heard so much of your beautiful island that I have come to see it."
"I'm very glad to see you," said the monkey.
"By the by," said the jellyfish, "have you seen the palace of the Dragon King of the Sea where I live?" "I have often heard of it, but I have never seen it," answered the monkey.
"Then you ought most surely to come. The beauty of the palace is beyond all description. It is certainly the most lovely place in the world," said the jellyfish, and he described the beauty and grandeur of the Sea King's palace. The monkey grew more and more interested and came down the tree.
"I should love to come with you," he sighed, "but I can swim."
"There is no difficulty about that. I can carry you on my back," said the jellyfish.
So the excited monkey leaped onto the jellyfish's hard shell, and the creature plunged into the sea. Thus, they went along, skimming through the waves,
until they were about halfway, when the jellyfish began to feel more and more sorry for the terrible fate that lay ahead for the monkey. With a sigh, he told the monkey everything, how he was to be killed for his liver to save the dragon queen. The poor monkey was horrified and very angry at the trick played upon him, but he was clever, so tried to keep calm and think of some way to escape. A bright thought struck him, and he said quite cheerfully,
"What a right it was, Mr. Jellyfish, that you did not tell me before we left the island. I have several livers and would happily have given you one, but I have left them all hanging on the pine tree."
The jellyfish was very disappointed, for he believed the story.
"Never mind," said the monkey. "Take me back to where you found me, and I will fetch a liver."
The pleased jellyfish turned his course towards Monkey Island once more, but no sooner had he reached the shore than the sly monkey scampered up into the pine tree and jeered at him.
"Of course I won't give you my liver, but come and get it if you can,"
mocked the monkey. There was nothing for the jellyfish to do but return to the Dragon King and confess his failure. Of course, the Dragon King was beside himself. With fury, he ordered a terrible punishment that all the bones were to be drawn out from the jellyfish body, that he was to be beaten until his shell broke off and then banished from the palace. The jellyfish, humiliated and horrified beyond all words, cried out for pardon. But the Dragon King's order had to be obeyed, and that is why the descendants of the jellyfish have all been soft and boneless, just as you see them today, thrown out by the waves high upon the shores of Japan. The end.